Sunday Morning on CBS. And here again is Lee Cowan.
He started off as a lowly resident of the underwater city of Bikinibon. Since then, SpongeBob SquarePants has truly risen to the top. One day, on a Sunday from right. Behind the gates in Nickelodeon Studios in Burbank, California, some tropical trouble was brewing in an undersea pipe.
This letter's just chocolate.
It's a preposterous coastal predicament.
Yeah, he pulls it out of his nose.
Yeah, yeah. But SpongeBob's Tom Kent has gotten pretty used to it.
Maybe it just needs a little extra elbow grease. See? What did I tell you?
Chuck, we can't tell me what all this means.
Do you know what this means?
It's amazing. Like, this wasn't supposed to happen, or this hardly ever happens.
Oh! Who lives in a pineapple under the sea? SpongeBob and his undersea buddies have become a multi-billion-dollar-a-year franchise for our sister network, Nickelodeon. They spawned countless video games, internet memes, action figures, three feature films.
Whoa! What is this place?
Even a Broadway musical.
It's the best day ever.
And in just 10 days, he'll celebrate his 25th anniversary. Or as SpongeBob himself might call it.
SpongeBob lets his freak flag fly. He is who he is. And it's amazing that folks find that very empowering that are now grown-ups or even little kids now.
But what separates SpongeBob from all the other cartoons?
Hello! Welcome to my commercial! Would you like the convenience of a Krabby Patty at home?
Why does such an emotional connection remain for both kids and adults?
What are you two laughing about?
In part, it's the cast. Every one of them has been side by side since the very beginning.
And what an amazing gift you guys have given the people.
Like, no, but we got the gift.
Yeah, we really did the gift. Yes, it's our first best destiny, I always have.
You idiots ruined my perfect getaway! Now I have to get away again! Over again!
So why don't you get committed?
What struck me just like watching you guys today is that you still laugh at it.
That's the beauty of it.
We always will laugh at it.
Yeah. Well, Patrick still makes me laugh, and I kind of lose myself in Patrick.
Is mayonnaise an instrument?
No, Patrick, mayonnaise is not an instrument.
And then every one of these guys, I hear them. It's like I'm 8 years old, and I get it.
Not even an idiot would come all the way out here.
Oh, Mr. Patrick!
Oh, it's you.
Find out they're all actually friends in real life, let's just say there's a moment.
Strong men, big dudes, burly guys with beards have teared up when they say, they go, wow, you guys really hang out together. Well, yeah, they're like, that's so cool, man. Good.
This fantastically improbable world was dreamed up by a former marine biologist named Steven Hillenburg.
These are the Nickelodeon archives.
Although the inhabitants of Bikini Bottom are mostly genuine aquatic creatures.
Squidward's house, the tiki head, and SpongeBob's pineapple house.
Squidward, we don't need televisions. Not as long as we have our imagination.
Hillenburg thought it would be particularly funny if the sponge who lived in this time pool wasn't an actual sea sponge, but an ordinary kitchen sponge instead.
These are his shoes and socks, so this is an in-depth study of SpongeBob's footwear.
Hillenburg's premise was pretty simple. The happy-go-lucky SpongeBob wants nothing more than to be the best fry cook in the ocean.
I can't accept your money, Mr. Krabs. Grilling is my passion.
He has a pet snail named Gary.
Gary
and I are going to win the prize
for Mr. Krabs,
because
that's the
Krabby
Krab. Right, Gary?
And a dim-witted best friend who would try anyone's patience, except for SpongeBob's.
Is this the Krusty Krab?
No! This is Patrick!
the clarinet, because why not?
I didn't play any wrong notes.
An escaping single-celled organism hell-bent on stealing the Krabby Patty secret formula.
Hey, watch it! The secret formula!
Must be one of Krabs' tricks.
It's so bizarre and yet so simple, and now it's become this phenomenon.
So bizarre, so simple, so perfect.
Ramsey Nathan, president of Nickelodeon and Paramount Animation, argues that SpongeBob became, for Gen Z, what Mickey Mouse was to baby boomers.
One of the things I've always loved about SpongeBob personally is that SpongeBob reminds us of the kid inside of us all, truly. You know, that sweet, honest,
naive,
lovable kid in all of us.
And yet, it survives because it's much more than that.
If SpongeBob was nothing but optimistic, that wouldn't be a very good show. So SpongeBob does get down in the dumps. SpongeBob does get discouraged. SpongeBob does feel sad, but he bounces back. He comes back. You know, well, there's always tomorrow.
One of the happiest shows on TV, however, hit one of its saddest moments when, in November 2018, SpongeBob's creator, Steve Hooper, died after being diagnosed with ALS. He was only 57.
Was it hard going on after that?
It's more of a calling, I think, for me, because we want to carry on what he started.
I think our thing was the feeling like we should keep doing this if we can.
We have no choice, in a way. One generation, now a second, even a third. Come to Comic-Con events, not so much for autographs and pictures, but to tell their own stories.
I constantly get people coming up, and one of the first things, if not the first thing out of their mouth, is thank you for my childhood.
Right.
I had this 15-year-old girl came up to me in a con, and she said, I went through a period of great depression, and I wanted to kill myself. You made me want to keep living. And I mean, that's such an incredibly intense thing to hear, and I looked up, and there's her mother standing right behind her. She's sobbing.
It's incredible. I mean, if things like that happen all the time.
At a time when we all feel a little underwater, and the future seems clouded by the dense fog of pessimism, Uncanny and SpongeBob SquarePants are a gentle, albeit silly reminder that optimism and friendship remain just as valuable as the Krabby Patty formula itself.
Sometimes I try to find the downside, like just as a mental exercise. Dad, I can't find one. So if you come up with a downside, let me know.
Email me.
I'm the master reptile.